The answer is a little complicated. One, you have to stop ingesting it. So if you stop ingesting it, you need to avoid water with fluoride, and that means the coffee at the restaurants. That means they'll all assure you it's filtered. When you test it, it's not removing fluoride. They run it through carbon filter to remove the taste, but it's not fluoride free. So to find a fluoride free water, none of the filters will remove 100% of the fluoride. So for any length of time, they all fail in time. So use a water source that is known that is fluoride free. And that, you know, can be a well water, surface water, rain water, runoff water from snow melt. So avoid substances that contain a lot of fluoride. And it includes black tea, green tea, chamomile tea, and brick tea. Those are natural sources of fluoride, and they will poison you as well. The iodine is the element that your body needs to dislodge the fluoride. The fluoride poisons you by being attached to binding sites that the fluoride should not be on, and iodine will actually remove that. So you can increase your fluoride excretion by increasing your iodine intake. Magnesium is also an antidote to some of the damage that's caused by fluoride. Dr. Levi wrote a book called Death by Calcium. So calcium, we probably overdosed with calcium in our distorted diet of today. So I'm not recommending that you take calcium. I am recommending you increase your iodine intake. And the other way that you can get fluoride out of your body is through bone turnover. This is over time with good kidneys. Over time with good kidneys means that you need to remodel your bones. And the way you do that is you lift weights or you do strength training, because that makes the bone turn over. Postmenopausal women have much difficulty in getting bone turnover. So start early and work hard on that in your youth, because the older you get, the harder it is to get it out. It's also in the ligaments and joints. So also when you're weight training, be careful about overstressing the joints and the ligaments, because it does make them fragile. So that's how to mitigate the harm caused by fluoride. There is a mineral called serpentine, which Dr. Yamianis mentioned in his book, Fluoride, the Aging Factor. I haven't got any source of serpentine. I understand it's fairly rare. But those are my thoughts on how to mitigate the harm or get the fluoride out of your body.